motorboat that too. And I want you to listen very carefully and try to define antonyms. I know you are now all ready to listen. So let us begin. Before we proceed, make sure you are ready and prepared with your materials needed for today's lesson, such as ball pen and capsule. And most especially, pay attention and focus to our discussion. Okay, take a look at the picture. What have you observed? Okay, the size of an apple. All right. What about the size of an apple? Okay, it is big and small. Okay, what do you call that words? All right, it is an antonyms. Now, we shall define the antonyms, or in Arabic word, kalimatul mutabad. Okay, that is kalimatul or kalimatu al kalimatu mutabadatu. Okay. Now, let's define antonyms. What is antonyms? Okay. These are words that have opposite meanings. So, in Arabic, ما هي الكلمات المتضاد؟ ما هي الكلمات المتضاد؟ هي كلمة معاكسة لمعنى آخر. Okay. I repeat. هي كلمة معاكسة لمعنى آخر. All right. Okay, I have here an example. Okay. قريبٌ بعيدٌ. قريبٌ, children, meaning it is near. So what is the opposite of near? Of course, it is far. In Arabic, far is بعيدٌ. Okay. Near, قريبٌ, far, بعيدٌ. So the opposite of قريب is بعيد. Okay, another example, like جديدٌ قديمٌ. جديد means new. قديم means old. So the opposite of new is old. Like jadid, new, qadim, old. Okay, another example, yani misal, kabirun. Okay, kabirun, the opposite of kabir is sagirun. In English, big, and the opposite of big is small. All right, let's go to other example. Tawilun. The opposite of tawilun is qasirun. In English, tawil, tall. Qasir, short. Okay, another example is kathirun. Kathirun, many. Qalilun, few. Again, kathirun, many. Qalilun, few. So the opposite of many is few. The opposite of kathirun is qalil. Alright. Now, I want you to answer the self-assessment question. ما هي الكلمة المتضادة؟ ما هي الكلمة المتضادة؟ Okay, what are antonyms? Again, what are antonyms? Okay, learners, your answer is أيوة هي كلمة معاكسة لمعنى آخر. أيوة ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Or in English, these are words that have opposite meanings. Okay, and then for the question number two, give the opposite meaning, okay, of the following words. Jadidun. Okay, so what is the opposite meaning for jadidun? Aywa is what? Qadimun. Nice. Again, what is the opposite for kabirun? The opposite word for kabirun. Right, it is sagirun. Very good. Okay, now, another one is ba'idun. So, what is the opposite word for ba'idun? Okay. Okay, children, what is the opposite of words ba'idun? All right, is qaribun. Very good. Okay, let's practice what you have learned today by answering the following question. Okay, match the given words with its opposite and write the letter of the write the letter of the correct answer on the space provided for. Okay, number one. Tawilun. Okay, number one, tawilun. Okay, what is your answer? What letter? All right, letter A, it's qasirun. Okay, let's go to number two. Jadidun. Again, jadidun. Okay, your answer is letter B. All right. It's qadimun. Okay, let's go to number three. Qaribun. Again, qaribun. Okay, your answer is ba'idun, letter. All right, letter C. Next, we go to number four. Okay, number four is kabirun. Kabirun. Okay, your answer is letter. All right, letter D. It is sagirun. It is sagirun. Okay, next we go to number 5. Number 5 is kathirun. Again, kathirun. Okay. So, your answer is letter E, qalilun. Okay, learner, we're going to remember the following. Okay, I want you to remember this, learners. Okay. الكلمة المتضادة هي كلمة معاكسة لمعناها أو لمعنى آخر. Again, الكلمة المتضادة هي كلمة معاكسة لمعنى آخر. Or in English, these are words that have opposite meanings. Let's see how much you have learned today by answering the following question. Directions. Match column A with column B by connecting it. Okay, let me read the words. Kabirun, qaribun, qadimun, kathirun, wa qasirun. Again, in the column A, kabirun, qaribun, qadimun, kathirun, qasirun. Okay, now what is the match for kabirun? Okay, it's sagirun, right? You are correct. And then qaribun? Okay, baidun. Nice. How about qadimun? Okay, it's jadidun. Okay. Kathirun. Okay, the opposite for kathirun is qalilun. Okay, qasirun. Qasirun. Okay, the opposite is qawilun. Again, kabirun is big. The opposite of big is small. It is sagirun. Qaribun or near. The opposite of qarib is ba'id, far. So, now kathirun, the opposite of kathir is what? Qalil, aywa. So, kathir, many, in qalil, few. Okay, qadimun. So, what is the opposite for qadimun? Or old. So, the opposite for the old is jadid, new. And for the opposite of short or qasir is tall. طويل in Arabic. Alright. Okay, give the antonyms of the following Arabic words. Okay. Now, qadim. Okay. Qadimun. Aywa. Jadidun. Qaribun. Kathirun. Qalilun. Okay. Okay, qadimun, the opposite is jadidun. And then the jadidun, the opposite is qadimun. And qaribun, the opposite is, what is the opposite of qaribun? Aywa, ba'idun. Very good. Now, the opposite meaning for, or the opposite word for kathirun. Kathirun. I mean, yeah, kabirun. I'm sorry, kabirun. So, what is the opposite for kabirun? Aywa, qasir. Qasirun. Alright. Next. Qalilun. What is the opposite of qalilun? Aywa, qalilun is kathirun. Aywa. Good job, learners. I know you did well on this activity. I hope I was able to make a clear discussion of today's lesson, and I hope that you will learn something from the lesson that I discussed to you. And I hope the discussions after this lesson was clear and you have learned something new today. So to conclude our lesson for today, once again, this is teacher Amina Jamari Julkanain. Barakallahu fikum wa jazakumullahu khairan. Shukran. Keep safe, everyone.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A pleasant morning to my beloved pupils of grade 1. I am teacher Jahara Ayla Ja'alam, your Islamic values teacher for today. Kaifa halukum ya atfal, mauno-uno na kamu mga anak murid. I hope you are fine today. So our topic for today is about lesson 4, I make myself pure and clean. Okay, hadi pa kita makapagtagna sin pangadian ta, suway kamu sadya dumungog marayaw, ningkod kamu marayaw, salta kaon nyo encapsulate nyo iban sin ballpen nyo, hasupaya hikasulat nyo in mga kalalagihan, isulat. Okay, so for us to be guided, let me read the objectives of our lesson. Okay, number 1, recite the Shahadatain or the testimony of faith. Basaha in dua pagsaksi. Number 2, perform the proper steps of wudu or the ablution. Hinanga in aturan marayaw sin pag-air. And the third, recognize the importance of God Allah Ar-Razak, the everlasting sustainer in one's life. Lagway ing kabasaran sintuhan Allah, magdidihir Rizki. Way katubtuban sin pagdihil niya Rizki, hakabuhi sin hangkatao. So now let's proceed to understanding. So hukaban niyo yung capslet niyo. Aun kakitaan niyo rin doon, tutaud niya, anak murid. Ingan niya, Hisali, Hirafi, Iban, Yusuf. Okay, so let's listen to their conversation. Dungukun na to in pagsambung laong sinto mag-classmate.
Yusuf, our teacher told us to always wash hands with soap and clean water. Yusuf, nag-iyan in mastal daran papaghugasun in lima sin sabon iban tubig.
Yes, we wash our hands every time we perform sala. We do that 5 times a day. Hoon, maghugas kita niyo lima na to sa kahaba magsambahayang.
That is wudu. We also do it before reading the Quran. Bihan in pagwudu, magwudu da isab sumamasa Quran. Okay, so amuyat to in pagsambung laong sinto mag classmate. So nangasubo, nagdihil sila idea. Yusuf, nagbaitain mastal niya, suway sila daran papaghugasun sin sabun iban sin tuwig malano. Okay, damikyan, inagi isabi Yusuf, na bihat tura isab apabila kita magsambahayang na maghugas da isab kita sin limata. So, inhantang niya bang magsambahayang, subay kita mag-air. Okay, iban bang magbasa isab Quran, subay resab kita mag-air. Okay. So, I keep myself pure and clean. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is delighted in me. So, daran ko paglanuan, iban, susihun in baran ko, supaya makuyag kako in Allah ta'ala. So, in Allah ta'ala, in kabayaan niya, katu subay kita, malano. Masusi, ibansin, malano. So, baon sa rapat, subay kita daran mag-ail, maghugas, sin, pamarananta. Supaya malayo kita nyo din ha, mga sakit, luba na sakit bihaon yan, subay kita daran maghugas sin limata. Okay, so halianta, kugdanan kita si mga COVID sakit yan, makawa din ha mga, uno din ha mga lumi, amin sakit di pagkakitaan. So, subay kita mag-ayad. So, marikita nyo pa self-assessment question number 1. Okay, what are the ways of keeping your body clean? So, unuin mga aturan hikalanu sinbaran. Okay, so mataud pa din ha mga aturan hikalanu sinbaran. Uno naman, so bang nyo kaingatan? Okay, so marayaw. So hibay ta ko kaniyo bang uno naman in mga aturan hikalanu sinbaran. So keeping our body clean, ikaisa, brushing our teeth 2 times a day. Subay ra kita magbrush sin ipon makaduahang kaadlaw. Okay, number 2, taking a bath every day. Subay kita mamaygu adlaw-adlaw supaya kita malano. Number 3, combing our hair with a clean comb. Manuglay sin suglay malano. Number 4, clipping or trimming our nails shorts. Manuptup sin kuko, bukon pasaran in kukutayan maghawa. Kasuran siya sin kakaw malumi mahinang tasakit. So subay siya tuptupan. Ikalima, washing our hands before each meal. So, hugasan in lima hadi pa kumaon. Atawa before and after eating. Subay kita maghugas in lima ta. adi pa kita makakaon, iban mang kita isab maubos na kumaon, subay resab kita humukasin, limata hasupaya kita malano. Okay, so nakakakamu pangajian dito mga bata, alhamdulillah. Okay, biyaon pangajion ta in mga steps when performing wudu. Okay, dungog kamu marayaw ini in aturan si pagambil wudu. Hasupaya kita makasambahayang, subay kita magwudu na amuna. Sabab in wudu, amu ini in hinang, hadi pa kita maka tindog sin sambahayang. Okay, hika isa, make niya or the intention to perform wudu. So, magniat bang tumagna na mag-ail. Okay, niyatun muna halom sin pangatayan mo in ikaw yaon mag-ail karna in ikaw sumambahayang. Okay, number two. Recite Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Inhatin niya, masa sin lapal Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Inhikatu, wash your hands. Humugasin 25 makatu. Ikaupat, rinse your mouth. Gumguman in simud makatu. Inikalima, sniff water then blow it out of your nose 3 times. Humanggit tubig hailong. Ampa mo hisunga makatupag balikan. So in hikal unum, wash your face. Hukasan in bayhu makatu. Okay, so in paghukas ta sin bayhu, amin bayhu tayan sa suku sin wala tiwuan sin buhok, doon haunahan, katan yan, part yan sin bayhu ta. So, hukasan in bayhu makatu. Ikapito, wash your arms up to your elbows. Humukas, inbuktun tubtub pasiku. Makauna in tuu ang papalawa. Pagbalikan, makatu. Biarasin, hinang mo hakaibanan. Okay, hatin niya, humukas kita sinbuktun. Tub-tub pasiko, intuo, makatu, humuhukasan. Pag-ubos, ang paisa, matunisab ko palawa, makatu, isab, hukasan. Ikawalo, with your head, sumapusin u, makatu. Ikasyam, with your ears inside and out. Sapuhun, intay nga palawong pagwa, makatu. Okay. And then, ikahangpu, wash your feet. Hukasan in siki, tub-tub, pabuku-buku. Makauna in tuu, ampa, palawa, makatu. So, hukasan mo in siki mo, tuu, makatu, pag-ubos, ampa, isab ko, matunpa. Siki mo, dapit palawa, makatu, isabin pag-hukas mo. Tub-tub pa, buku-buku, bang mag-hukas. Hasupaya lumano maigin lumi. Maubos man in mga hinangyat to, ampa na kita mang duaa. Okay, so isayang tayin 25 tabiahan, mang duaa kita, i-recite ta, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashadu anna muhammadan rasulallah. So amu ini in lapal, basa hunta. So, masa sin lapal, ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna muhammadar rasulallah. So, amuyat to. Okay. So, nakaingat na kamu bang biyariin in pag-air? Muramurahan, mag-anad kamu, isuring kanyo in nakapangaji haadlaw ini. So, mari kita nyo pa self-assessment question. Question number 2. So, pangasubo. So, what are the steps in performing wudu? So, uno in mga aturan sin pag-ambil ail. Okay, so balikan ta ha, supaya katumtuman. So, magniat kita, bang tumagna na in mag-air. Ikarua, masa sinlapal bismillah. Inhika tu humugas, sin dua, lima makatu. Pag-ubos, gumguman in simod, makatu. Ubus humanggit sin tubig hailong ampamuhisunga makatu pagbalikan. Inhika lima, inhika unum isa bukasan in bayhu makatu. Okay, hinika pito humuras sin buktun tubtub pa siku. Okay, makauna into ampapalawa pagbalikan makatu. Ikawalo sumapusin o makatu. Inikasiam, sapuhon intay nga palaumpakuwa makatu. Ubos inikahang po, hugasan insiki tubtub pabuku-buku, makauna intu ang papalawa makatu. Sarta bang naubos na in mga steps yato na ampa na kita mag-recite sin babasahan halapal ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna muhammadar rasulallah. So, dahin hatu sampul na na in pag ayin or in pag ambil wudu ta. Okay. So, mari kita niyo aun de indi pagnganan. Let's practice. Okay. So, kauning capslet niyo iban sin ballpen niyo. Jawaban tayin mga pangasubo ini. So, basahon ko in directions, dungog ka mo. And silker the picture that shows good habit. Hati niya, ligungi in patta amuin magpakita adat marayaw. Okay, so on din dun patta-patta ha-capslate niyo. Patta number one, bata-bata. Eating while walking. Hati niya, magkaunsar ta miyamanaw. Okay, so in ligungan mo, amin marayaw in habit. Marayaw in adat, ha? Magpakita sin pangadatan marayaw. Ikarua, washing the fruits before eating it. Ugasan in bungang kahoy nasung kumaon. Atin niya bang ang mga bungang kahoy, biyan na sin mga mangga, apple, ununonap. Ugasan muna siya muna ang pamukaunon. Ikatu, throwing banana peel on the ground. Ubus kimaun saing in batabatayaon, biugit na paisaing. Hati niya, magbugit paisaing halantay. Marayaw ba yan o mangi? Okay. Next picture, buying street foods without cover. Magbi makaunharan, wairoon saob o wailukub niya. Pagkaw, marayaw ba yan? Okay, onyan waktu in langaw maglupad-lupad na doon. Okay, next, cleaning the street, maglano sindan. At wala labayan sin kita, lanuan. Okay. And last, combing the hair, magsuklay buhok. Okay, so how nurunin mga kakahinang ikarayaw sin baran na to. Okay, so naubos na kamo nag-answer. Okay, so mari kita nyo pa, sadya kamo pa lesson 5. Okay, marayaw in pangajian din di makakatud kita, pangajian marayaw. So in topic niya ri, what are you waiting for? Hati niya, uno pa in tagaran mo? So in title niya, The Ants. Okay, so basahon ko dungog kamo marayaw. One day, a lazy man saw 100 of ants. Each ant carries food. Hati niya, in ants yaon, mga tausog, in sanam. Okay, nakita na kamo sanam. Okay. Hambok adlaw, nakita in usog, lisuan. Yatusan sanam. Tiap-tiap hambok, din kanila nagdara kakaon. So they are helping each other in carrying big food. Finally, they carried the food into the hall. So magtulong tabang in pakanya-kanya hapagdasing kakaon malago. Intubtuban nara nila yung pagkaon palomsin lungag. Okay, so, aun pa nga subo. What is the moral lesson in the story? So, unuin makawa pangadian hakisa sinsanam. Okay. Very good. Atinyain mga sanam ini. In sila ini, matibut, iwan matuyo. No, iwan, in sila magtabang tiyabangi. Magtabang-tabang sila, di sila magpasad. Okay, so biyaturay sab in pangadatan sin kita marayaw, subay magtabang-tabang, iwan, di sila magpikil sin luog nila. So hard work, they work hard. Okay, so that they can reap the benefits tomorrow. So magtaw sila pagkaon nila supaya hasusungon aun makawa mahampit nila. Okay. So in virtues of hard work and planning for the future. So in moral lesson amuyatin makata. So aun sila pagtabang-tabang iban matibot sila. Okay. So mari kita pa let's practice. Okay, answeran nyo isab ini. Okay, I will read the directions. Okay, complete each sentence. Underline the correct word inside the parenthesis. Okay, hati niya, jukupa ingkabtangan, good listen, in bunal halomsin, baugan. Okay, basahon ko, underline na nyo sadya, in pagpian nyo dua word. Okay, one day, a lazy lad, man sat under the tree. He saw hundreds of rats or ants. They were all organized and running, moving. Each ant carries food, stone. They are helping, stepping each other in carrying big food. Finally, they carried the food into the mall hole. Okay, so tausog niya. Hambukad law in lisuan subul. Magpika mo inan sa lisuan ka or subul. Usog, naglilingkod hasom kahoy. Nakita siya giyatusan mga ambaw atawa sanam. So, unin answer niyo. Ambaw yung kita niya or sanam. In sila katan, nagtutukot yukuhi. Iban, dimaragan, himihibal. Unagunin sanam, dimaragan or himihibal. Okay, pagpian yung answer yan. So, tiap-tiap sanam, nagdara, kakaun, bato. Okay, unin diarasin sanam, kakaun ataw bato. So, in sila, nagtulong, tabang, nagmamahil. Okay, hapagda, simpagkaun, maaslag. Ha, kahinapusan, nara nila, impagkaun, palaom, lungag or taylalat. Okay, so pinakamuang jawab niyo. Okay, so basta huntay niya supaya di takalupahan. As a Muslim, we have to affirm the ashadatain. Ashadu an la ilaha illallah. I bear witness that there is no God except Allah. Wa ashadu anna Muhammad, Muhammad is his messenger. In Muslim, subay siya mga hagad hadua saksi. Magsaksi ako inway Tuhan mapatut pagtag-ipunan malengkan Allah. Iban magsaksi ako in Muhammad daaksin Allah. So we should apply the values of cleanliness and personal hygiene. Subay tahinangon in pangadatan marayaw biya nasin maglano iban sin pagsusi sin ginhawabaran. Okay, we have to be hard working like the ants. Subay kita matibut biasin sanam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ar-Razzaq, the everlasting sustainer. In Allah, siya in magdidirijiki, di magbugtuin, dirihilan niya. Okay, so let's see how much you have learned today. Kita unta kuno bang hariin na in kiyahatihan yung adlaw ini. So, jawaban niyo in mga pangasubo ha-assessment. Okay, so direction number one, the following steps of wudu are not in the correct number. or order which should come first. So number them from 1 to 11. Write the number inside the small box. So wala na susun-susun in aturan sin pag-ayil, pagsunua. Umbuli day na hambuok pahangpo tagisa. Sulatan in umbul halom sin tuong. So amo na yan in mga steps sin wudu, butangan nyo siya number 1 hang up to pa 11. Okay. So hikaruwa exercise niyo, name each part of the picture, then color it. So aun din dun araw timudlo ha mga patta yan. So ngani injinisan sin patta pagubos ang pamu warna i. Why na with that warna in hibutang mo. Okay. So dito na timubtub in pangajian ta. Alhamdulillah mura-murahan makaka kamu pangajian den kamu adlaw ini. Wabillahi taufik wal hidayah. This is Teacher Jahara saying wa ilal lika. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah. Assalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Wa ba'd. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. Marayawat law kan yung katan dimurungog ha programa na to. Di ha kasusuban na to a registration di triple X. Hadlaw ini, yari na isab, ika niyo tuwanta ha?
Van teacher niyo dayang.
Nagbalik ha, para ha pangadyaan na to, impangadyaan na to hadlaw ini, amunain, pagtaat parwa maas. Halihalihanta niyo na ahang karay, para ha patumtum ini, stay tuned.
أشرقت نفسي بنور من فؤادي حينما رددت يا رب العباد وانتشت روحي وصار الدمع يجري يا إله.
الحمد لله يا ريني سبك منك بليك إبان سينك مويان دمس مسي دمرونغوغ kaputin niyo, iwan ukaban niyo, encapsulate niyo, magdungan-dungan tanyo, basahon, suy-suy ini.
It was Saturday morning. Fatima and Ummi are very busy cleaning their house and backyard. This is a time for helping their parents. Omar is busy reading his book. His father said, "My son, please help Ummi clean our backyard." Omar replied, "Adi, I still have many things to study. Our ustad assigned me to read my kitab." His father said, "But today is Saturday. You still have time to do your assignment. Didn't your ustad teach you about obedience to parents? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards those who obey their parents." Omar answered, "Sorry, Abi. Yes, our ustads taught us to obey our parents. Allah ta'ala favors children who are obedient to their parents. I will just fix my things, then I will help Ummi clean the backyard." "Thank you, my son," his father replied. "He will go to mall with Fatima and Ummi after you're done cleaning."
May naatin adlaw sabto, naglano bay iwan halaman hi Fatima kay ina niya. Amo in wakto tumabang hamaas niya. Nagbabas sa kitab hi Omar. Agi hi ama niya, "Uto, tabangi hi ina mo maglano halaman hatay kudbay." Insambong hi Omar kanama niya, "Ama, yari pa ako nangangadji. Aun kitab yabas sa kamu sinustaz na mo." Agisin ama adlaw ini Sabto. Aun pa wakto mo huminang sinhinang tuhon kay mo. Mahi, wala kau hinduan sinustaz tungod pagta at pamaas. Gandahan sin Allahu Ta'ala bang hisisyo imagta at parwa maas niya. Sambung hi Omar, maaf ama, hinduan kami sinustaz na mo magta at pamaas. Kaulungan kau sinallahu ta'ala. In bata nagtaat pamaas niya, mumusun ko sadya im mga kitab ko. Ampa ako matto, tumabangkan ina maglano sin halaman hatay ko. Magsukol anak, sambung sin ama niya kanya. Matto kita niyo patinda, hi Fatima iban hi ina mo pag-uhos niyo maglano. Hali-alihan tanyo na hangkaray, ayaw kong mag-ig, di high station tanyo, di triple X, magbalik da kami, stay tuned. Alhamdulillah, yari na isab kita nung nagbalik, damikyanin ka mo masimasi, dimurungog, haprograma tanyo. Bihaon, lumatun kita nyo, pa self-assessment question. Number one,
what is obedience?
Uno, inhati simpagtaat. Number two,
what are the deeds showing obedience to parents?
Uno naman in hinang marayaw, hipagmarayaw ta parwa maasta. Tumtumun taniyo, ayaw taniyo kalupahan. Bunal tuo din Allahu Ta'ala, tungbasan niya in bata atawa anak, nagtaat parwa maas niya. Pasal impagtaat parwa maas, lawang papagtaat pa Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Hangkan, suway tanyo di pahil-pahilun, impagtaat ataw pagmarayaw tanyo, parwa maas tanyo. Sabab, bang kita nyo nagmarayaw parwa maas, biada kita nakapagmarayaw, fa Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Hangkan na imbata, suway siya mapanday, pakuyahun niya indwa maas niya, hasupaya in Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala kumuyag kaniya. Sabab, in kuyag sin Allahu Ta'ala, doon tanyo kabakan, hakuyag sin duamaas tanyo. Iban imbungsi atawa astul sin Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, doon tanyo kabakan, habungsi iban astul sin duamaas tanyo. Bihaon, sulayan tanyo, bang unuin nakawa tanyo pangadjian, haadlaw ini hatungod simpagtaat parwa maas. Kawa kamu katas niyo iwan simpensil niyo. Sulatan niyo hakatas niyo bunal bang ingkap tangan ini imamu. Sulatan niyo hakatas niyo bukon bang ingkap tangan ini wala imamu. Number one,
obedience to parents is a way of obedience to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
Impagtaat pamaas, lawang siya papagtaat pa Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Number two,
a child should follow all orders of his her parents.
In bata, suway magad hapaminturo si maas niya. Number three,
Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala rewards a child for obeying his her parents.
Tungbasan sin Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala in bata nagtataat pamaas. Number four,
Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala punishes a child for not obeying his her parents.
Siksaun sin Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in bata di magtaad pamaas. Number 5.
Obey your parents next to your friends.
Magtaad na pamaas ang papakabagayan. Mahuli, mamaid na kami kaniyo. Ini hika ni tuantaha iban
Teacher Dayang
Habaliwasan Central School Sped Center MEP Teacher COS. Salam kasila sa kaniyukatan. Wa ilalika.
Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A blessed day to you, my beloved learners. How are you today? I hope you're doing well. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum. Welcome to Arabic Language, Grade 6, Week 7 and 8. This is Teacher Napisa H. Ainadi, your teacher for today. Before we start our lesson, make sure you are in a comfortable place. Get your capsulet, ball pen, paper, and notebook for you to jot down important matters during discussions. Children, listen carefully and attentively. Try to comprehend our lesson for today. Okay, children, are you ready? So let's begin. Our topic for today is about as-sifatu. Meaning of as-sifatu is adjective. For us to be guided in today's lesson, our objectives are: number one, give the meaning of adjective. Number two, identify the adjective in a sentence. To start with, let us first define as-sifatu or the adjective. As-sifatu ta'ti ba'dal ismi lituwaddihahu. Wa idha kana al-mawsufu ma'rifatan, kanat as-sifatu ma'rifatan. Idha kana al-mawsufu nakiratan, kanat as-sifatu nakiratan. It means that the adjective comes after the noun to clarify or describes it. If the adjective is common noun, the word after it should also be common noun. If the adjective is proper noun, the word after it should also be proper noun. Okay, children, did you understand? Let's continue. Okay, let's read a paragraph using adjectives. The title of paragraph is Al-Kitabu, meaning the book. Al-Kitabu al-Mufidu, Sadiqun Nafi'un. والذي يقرأ الكتاب يعرف شيئا كثيرا من الحياة. The useful book is a valuable friend. Whoever reads a book knows many things in this life and does not get bored. الكتاب جليس لا يمل جليسا. والكتاب وعاء مملوء علما وهو ناطق ينطق عن الأحياء ويتحدث عن الموتى. The book is a container that full of knowledge and wisdom. It tells the life of an individual and the story of his death. والقرآن الكريم خير الكتب أنزله الله ليهدي به الناس إلى الصراط المستقيم. And the Holy Quran is the best book that Allah sent to guide mankind. Okay, children, are you still with me? The adjective used in this paragraph are Al-Mufidu. It means useful. Next, Nafi'un, valuable. Next adjective, Kathiran, many. Another adjective used is Mamlu'un, full. And the last adjective we got from the paragraph is Al-Mustaqim, guide. Now, children, let's answer this self-assessment question. Okay, what is adjective? Ma ma'na as-sifa? Okay, we will answer. The meaning of as-sifatu is as-sifatu ta'ti ba'da al-ismi lituwaddihahu. Wa idha kana al-mawsufu ma'rifatan kanat as-sifatu ma'rifatan. إذا كان الموصوف نكرة كانت الصفة نكرة. Meaning, the adjective comes after the noun to clarify or describe it. If the adjective is common noun, the word after it should also be common noun. But if the adjective is proper noun, the word after it should also be proper noun. Okay, let's practice what we have learned today. Directions. Tawjihun. ضع خطا تحت الصفة في الجمل الآتية. Underline the adjective in the following sentences.
Number one sentence. Hadihi khariqatun nafi'atun. Okay, where is the adjective in this sentence, children? Okay, let's answer. The answer is nafi'atun. Okay, are you done? Number two. الرجل المسلم meaning the man is Muslim. So where is the sifa in this sentence? Okay, the answer is المسلم. Number three. القميص الصفراء جديد. Meaning, the yellow shirt is new. Okay, where is the asifa in this sentence? Okay, the answer is safra'u. Okay, class, did you get it? I hope so. Now, let's remember these key points. As-sifatu ta'ti ba'da al-ismi lituwaddihahu. Wa idha kana al-mawsufu ma'rifatan كانت الصفة معرفة. إذا كان الموصوف نكرة كانت الصفة نكرة. Meaning, the adjective comes after the noun to clarify or describe it. If the adjective is common noun, the word after it should also be common noun. And if the adjective is proper noun, the word after it should also be proper noun. Okay, children, clear? Now, let's how much have you learned today? Answer this self or assessment. Directions. Taujihun. Daqafan tahta sifati fil jumalil atiyati. Number one. Albaytul kabiru jamilun. Again, albaytul kabiru jamilun. It means that the big house is beautiful. Just underline the adjective. Number two. Ash-shajaratu al-khadra'u kathiratu al-thimari. Again, ash-shajaratu al-khadra'u kathiratu al-thimari. Meaning, the green tree has many fruits. Number three. الطالب الزكي قد نجح في الامتحان. Meaning, the bright student passed the examination. Okay. Okay, number 4. Al-mudarrisu al-mahiru syaraha ad-darsa. Again, al-mudarrisu al-mahiru syaraha ad-darsa. Meaning, the teacher or the expert teacher explained the lesson. And number 5. At-tabibu as-satiru yu'alijul marida. Meaning, the expert doctor is giving medicine to the patient. Okay, children, that's all for today. It's time for me to say bye now. I hope that you understand well and learned something new. Keep on studying and reading ahead of time for you to comprehend well the lesson taught. Again, this is Teacher Napisa H. Ainadi saying, Wadaan, ilan niko.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah. Assalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Wa ba'd. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuhu. Marayaw adlaw kaniukatan dimurungog ha programa na to di ha kasusuban na to radio station di Triple X. Haadlaw ini, yari na isab hika ni Tuan Taha
Wani Teacher Dayang
nagbalik para hapangadjian na to. In pangadjian na to, haadlaw ini, amunain Why do Muslim pray? Maita in Muslim suway magsambahayang. Halialihanta na ang karay para hapatumtum ini. Stay tuned. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alamin. Yari na isab kami nagbalik. Ibansin kamu yanda masimasi dimurungog. Kaputin niyo, iban ukaban niyo, encapsulate niyo. Magdungan-dungan kita niyo, basahon impangadjian ini. Impangadjian taniyo haadlaw ini. Why do Muslim pray? Mayta in Muslim suway magsambahayang. Basahon na to na ha English, hisalin na to pabahasa sinog.
Performing Salah. Allahu Ta'ala orders all Muslim to pray 5 times a day. We call this prayer Salah. It is the second pillar of Islam. Praying 5 times a day is the first step to worship Allahu Ta'ala. It is the key to enter paradise. When a Muslim prays, he talks to his Creator, Allahu Ta'ala.
In Allahu Ta'ala, nang daaki pakatan Muslim, in suway magsambahayang 5 waktu hatiap-tiap adlaw. In tawag ha-ibadat ini, amuna in sala atawakan sambahayang. Siyana in hikarwa rukun, deng ha mga rukun sin Islam 5. Impagsambahayang lima waktu, amunay ni impanagnaan ibadat pa Allahu subhanahu wa ta'ala, sarta siya kunsi siya sinsulga. Bangin Muslim magsambahayang, in siya di managbisara iban sin nagpapanjarikan niya Allahu ta'ala. Bihaon lumatun kita niyo pa self-assessment question. Number one,
what are the five obligatory prayers?
Uno-uno naman in sambahayang lima waktu.
Number two, what is the importance of prayer?
Uno in kahalgaan sin pagsambahayang lima waktu.
Prayers. Salah is part of Islam. Prayer have five times obligatory prayers. These are Fajr, Dhuhr, Asar, Maghrib, and Isha. It is important to do these obligatory prayers because it is commanded by our God, Allahu Ta'ala, to observe our prayers daily, especially to those Muslim who are obliged to do it. When you do prayer, you gain reward from Allahu Ta'ala. But when you forbid in performing it, you will be punished in the hereafter. So, it is important for a Muslim to perform prayer.
In sambahayang hambuok siya deng harukun sin Islam. In sambahayang aun siya lima waktu, wajib subay tunayun. Amunain Fajar, Zuhur, Asar, Maghrib, Iban Isha. In sambahayang lima waktu, mahal ka siya subay hinangun. Pasal in sambahayang ini, daakan sinallahu ta'ala. In subay siya hitunay makalima hatiap-tiap adlaw. Labi aula ha mga naggugulal Muslim. Bangkaw timunay sin sambahayang madawhat mo intung bas deng ha Allahu Ta'ala. Sa bang mutinggalan impagtunay kaniya, siksaon kau sin Allahu Ta'ala ha adlaw mahuli. Hasawabi ato, mahal ka ha Muslim in subay siya tumunay sin sambahayang lima waktu. Halialihanta niyo na ang karay, ayaw ko mag-ig, iban ay ko magpindachun. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alamin, yari na isab kita niyo nagbalik. Iwan sing kamu yanda masimasi di murungog hari gestation kasusuban taniyo di triple X. Alhamdulillah, nakakawa kita niyo pangadjian hatungod sing pagsambahayang lima waktu. Bihaon tumtumun taniyo.
Performing salah means obedience to Allahu Ta'ala. When we perform salah, it makes a person avoid doing wrong things and make him remember Allah all the times. Every time he pray, and it can be make one use.
Impagtunay sin sambahayang ini, pagtaat, iban pag-ibadat fa Allahu Ta'ala. Bangkita timunay sin sambahayang in ini mangdahi kato humalli deng ha mga hinang mangi. Iban manumtum kaniya fa Allahu Ta'ala. Hakatan waktu. Iban ha waktu siya magsambahayang mahinang siya hambuok deng ha mga nagmamabuga fa Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Hal yato nakawatan yung resab pangadjian in kahalgaan sin pagsambahayang tungbas dirihilan deng ha Allahu Ta'ala. Demikian in mamahil pahil atau maninggal kaniya aunday sabsiksa kaniya haadlaw kanagana. Deng hamanga kahalgaan simpagsambahayang suway makalipa kakatu tanyo in uno-uno hinang tanyo sabab amunaon impanagnaan ibadat asubuhon kato tanyo haadlaw kiyama pasar simpagsambahayang. Nabang siya dimayaw, dimayaw ingkatan kakahinang tanyo. Sagawa bang insambahayang kimangi besim pagpahil-pahil ataw pagtinggal tanyo, magadda isab kumangi ingkatan kakahinang tanyo. Halialihan tanyo na ang karay, ayoko mag-ig, stay tuned. Sulay-sulayan tanyo na bang uno impangadjian na kawa tanyo haadlaw ini. Kawaan niyo, ingkatas niyo, iban pensil niyo, yari ang mga pangasuwo. Sulatan niyo, bunal, bang imbitsara imamo. Iban sulatan niyo, bukon, bang imbitsara wala imamo.
Number one, all people should perform salah.
Kataan tao suway magtunay sin sambahayang.
Number two, salah is a part of Islam.
In sambahayang, bahagian siya sin Islam.
Number three, salah makes a person avoid doing wrong things.
In sambahayang, mangdahi hatao humalli deng hahinang mangi.
Number four, performing salah means obedience to Allah Ta'ala.
In pagtunay sin sambahayang ini, pagtaat iwan pag-ibadat fa Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
Number five, salah has one obligatory prayer only.
In sambahayang, aun siya hambuok wajib fardu. Insha'Allah, next week, dugaing nasab pangadjian immakawatan niyo. Mura-murahan, papagbarakatun sinallahu ta'ala ing mga nakawa na to pangadjian haadlaw ini iwan haadlaw susungon mahuli mamaid na kami kaniyo ini hika ni tuantaha
Vani Teacher Dayang
Dainha Baliwasan Central School SPED Center MEP Teacher COS Salam kasila sa kaniyo katan wa ilal liqa.
Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.
Allahu Allah.